And now, ladies and gentlemen, we head to a personal affair. Two former friends facing each other in a match, and the question that remains here that needs to be answered is, will Tommy Douglas attack Richard Hawkins? I mean, he tried to talk some sense into his buddy on War this past week. Richard Hawkins didn't listen. Richard Hawkins dropped Tommy Douglas. I mean, a lot is riding in this man's head, and I mean, Richard Hawkins believes that in order to be successful, he needs to cheat to win, and he needs to forget everything he had in the past, forget his friends, forget everyone who cared about him, and in doing that, he's dropped Tommy Douglas. I mean, Tommy Douglas is trying to speak to him, but I mean, now they're going to have a match. The MPWF chairman has booked this match for Backlash, and again, will Tommy Douglas attack Richard Hawkins, or will he sit back and try to speak to him in this match? Again, as we mentioned before, a lot is riding on this night. The MPWF War Superstars are really going at it. Looking back at me, and rightfully so, these fans booing Richard Hawkins. And there's Richard Hawkins making his way to the ring. Richard Hawkins wearing a brand new attire here in the MPWF. And if you didn't understand what Richard Hawkins is, his tights will tell you. Richard Hawkins says that he is legit. And again, I mean, you just look at the front of his tights. And I hope that that's the only thing you're looking at his tights for. Richard Hawkins making his way to the ring. Disregarded Tommy Douglas and everyone else who's cared for him in the MPWF. He blatantly said that the only way to make it in the MPWF is to cheat to win. He said, I don't see what's wrong with it. Cheating, screwing people out of matches. It seemed to be successful for everyone else, so why can't I try it? And that's what Richard Hawkins is doing. Richard Hawkins believes that cheating is the only answer. Richard Hawkins has not won a matchup since he lost the YouTube Championship at Bragging Rights. I mean, he thought he could defeat Tommy Douglas on War 2 weeks ago. I mean, Tommy Douglas is a man who has never beaten Richard Hawkins in one-on-one competition. And finally, 2 weeks ago, Tommy Douglas defeated him. You think Richard Hawkins would be happy for his friend? Hell no, Richard Hawkins wants to attack him. Richard Hawkins doesn't feel like it's right. He is extremely arrogant, and we are now learning about the true Richard Hawkins. We are now seeing his true ego shine through. And again tonight, if Richard Hawkins, well, I mean, if Tommy Douglas attacks Richard Hawkins is going to have to be at his A game. Cheating or not, Tommy Douglas is going to be a tough opponent to face. But I mean, I think that Tommy Douglas is going to have to fight Richard Hawkins in this matchup, because Richard Hawkins will not let up. And here we go, Tommy Douglas versus Richard Hawkins. And oh my god, Douglas with a net breaking. And he answered that question already. Tommy Douglas taking the fight to Richard Hawkins right off the bat. I mean, those are fist drops there by Tommy Douglas, and he is slapping and hitting the hell out of his former friend, Richard Hawkins. And I really stress that former friend, you don't drop the man who was looking after you, the man who was watching your back, the man who was trying to help you back to success. That was Tommy Douglas. That's who Richard Hawkins dropped for whatever reason. And Richard Hawkins is in trouble as Tommy Douglas is just beating the hell out of him. Holy Christ. And oh! Richard Hawkins fights back with the eye rake, and he's already back to those cheating methods. And Richard Hawkins getting out the ring, trying to separate some space between him and Tommy Douglas. That's the best thing that he can do at this point. Douglas telling Richard Hawkins to get back inside the ring. You can see our table's been fixed back earlier. Again, Chandrella Johnson has injured her knee. It seems that she's hyperextended it. And she has injured ribs, just like Sasha Fierce, just like Austin Taylor, just like Brie Bella, just like Michelle McCool. I mean, Helga has been on a warpath, and she has destroyed the women here in the MPWF, but it is a nice submission. Double underhook there you see by Richard Hawkins. He's applying it on Tommy Douglas. And this match has the potential to be extremely technical between both these men. And again, 2 weeks ago in War, they had a phenomenal technical wrestling contest. But I mean, the fuel that is fuming between these two men can change that completely. There's a net breaker there by Richard Hawkins. I mean, Richard Hawkins, there's no doubt that he is legit. Richard Hawkins is a hell of an athlete. I believe that Richard Hawkins should have been a world champion by now. But again, this is no reason to turn your back on your friends. And Tommy Douglas fights back with the knees there, trying to escape from the Dragon Sleeper. And now, oh, look at that. Tommy Douglas with some brutal knees right to the chest, the sternum of Richard Hawkins. And now there's the knife hand chops. And, oh, there's a huge elbow there by Tommy Douglas. And you see that Douglas has not yet gone for a submission in this matchup. Douglas has been focused on punishing Richard Hawkins. And there's an eye rake again by Richard Hawkins. And there's a bulldog. And it was effective. It did work. And Richard Hawkins now putting his feet on the rope. Referee Marty McFly telling him that you cannot get the pinfall if your foot is on the rope. I mean, look at this. Richard Hawkins cheating already. Looking to pick up this win against his former friend Tommy Douglas, and again, I continue to stress that there is no friendship between these two at all. Their relationship has been broken, and there's a double axe handle off the top rope by Tommy Douglas. Canada's own as he goes for the cover here. One, two, and Richard Hawkins getting the shoulder up, and I think this is too early to pin a competitor like Richard Hawkins. And now Douglas, nice takedown of his own. They'll go for a double underhook of his own there on Richard Hawkins. And Hawkins in trouble now, as Douglas is really applying the pressure here. And now Richard Hawkins having to fight back with the headbutts. And now, oh, shot there. Nice forearm taking down Tommy Douglas by Richard Hawkins. I mean, again, we've mentioned all through tonight the personal matches that will take place. The World's Heavyweight Championship. Helios Christ versus Brian Adams. The fate of MPWF War is on the line in that match. But there's a reversal. Tommy Douglas throwing Richard Hawkins out the corner. And now Tommy Douglas going for the half Boston Crab. Easily gets the votes for the most popular submission of the night here at Backlash. As Tommy Douglas applies the pressure on the ribs and the leg. But Richard Hawkins pulls out of that submission. And now Richard Hawkins, what's he looking to do here? Richard Hawkins. Oh, a huge atomic drop there. That was Hulk Hogan's best move. And now Richard Hawkins going for a nice neckbreaker takedown there as he drops Tommy Douglas. And now Richard Hawkins is proud of his actions, is proud of himself, and he picks up Douglas. And oh, what a DDT there by Richard Hawkins. A vile DDT. Now going for the cover, putting his foot on the rope again, directly in front of referee Marty McFly, and clearly that will be a rope break. Now I don't understand the game plan in that whatsoever. I don't know if Richard Hawkins is flaunting his new attitude or what. But if you continuously put your foot on the rope whilst the referee is looking, you will not get the pinfall. And Tommy Douglas with a reversal, sending Richard Hawkins to the outside of the ring. Now Douglas off the top rope, and now there's a forearm smash to the outside of the ring. And he is now beating the hell out of Richard Hawkins. And again, we talked about how Douglas has not used very many technical moves in this matchup, which is definitely different for the amazing technical wrestler in Tommy Douglas. He is a hell of an athlete, as Douglas now throws Richard Hawkins in the ring. Born out the Kamloops of Canada. Went to Toronto, Ontario, Canada to train to be a wrestler. We tell you every single match that Tommy Douglas is in, we tell you how good he is, because he is that damn good. And Tommy Douglas there with a huge snap DDT on Richard Hawkins. Now going for the cover here, that could be it. Hawkins may be down. One, two, three, and Richard Hawkins getting the shoulder up. Oh, knife hand chop there by Douglas. Shades of Chris Benoit with that knife hand chop. And now Douglas has Richard Hawkins in the proverbial precarious position as he is hung up on the ropes in a position that will adversely affect his sexual drive. But oh, Richard Hawkins fights back there. Richard Hawkins bouncing off the ropes, clotheslining Tommy Douglas, saving himself and his future children. And now Hawkins going right back to the submission again, right back to that double underhook. And Richard Hawkins, it seems that he's trying to turn this one into a technical wrestling match. He can see the fury in Douglas' eyes, and he doesn't want to mess with that at all tonight. So this crowd here in North Carolina has been hot for this event all night. There was a huge clothesline. And again, that might have busted his mouth there. One, two, and oh, Richard Hawkins getting the shoulder up. Extremely close matches we have watched tonight. And now there's a German suplex and a huge suplex at that by Tommy Douglas. And now going for the cover here. Putting the forearm in the face. One, two, three. And I think if Tommy Douglas would have hooked the leg for that pinfall, he would have won that match. And Richard Hawkins now being sent into the turnbuckle. And what's Douglas got on his mind here? Douglas now, ooh, popping him back up with another clothesline up the turnbuckle. That was some vicious impact by Tommy Douglas. And Douglas now with a nice suplex takedown there on Richard Hawkins. And now what's Douglas looking to do here? Richard Hawkins fights back out with the eye rake. And now there's a jab and a kick. And Richard Hawkins now resorting to some dirty tactics, realizing that Tommy Douglas does not want to lose this match at all tonight. And now you see how he chokes him out in the ropes. And oh, what a kick to the back there by Hawkins. And now Hawkins with the camel clutch submission. Tommy Douglas clearly has his hands on the rope, but Richard Hawkins has up to a 5 count before he has to let go. And he is going to hold on to that before he has to let go of that 5 count. He will fully use and take advantage of the 5 count of the referee. And there's another atomic drop by Richard Hawkins. And now Richard Hawkins showing his muscles to Tommy Douglas, which is rather stupid if you ask me, because Douglas is a bigger man than he is. And now there's a back suplex there by Richard Hawkins. But Richard Hawkins is legit, I guess. I mean, that's what he calls himself now. Richard Legit Hawkins. And now there's a dragon sleeper as Tommy Douglas is clearly on the ropes again. And he continues to utilize this submission hold. Richard Hawkins has no give, no care. This new attitude stinks. It sucks. Now Richard Hawkins picking up Tommy Douglas here. And now Irish Whip sending him back to the turnbuckle once again. And now look at this. What is he looking to do here? Richard Hawkins is in trouble. Sorry, Tommy Douglas is in trouble. Richard Hawkins is all good. And now this is going to be disgusting right here. He has him up, ladies and gentlemen. A back suplex up the top rope. And look at the way Tommy Douglas just folded in half from that suplex. And that may be it. Richard Hawkins may have finished this match 3-0. My goodness, Tommy Douglas gets the shoulder up. Douglas does not want to lose to Richard Hawkins on this night. And there's another DDT by Richard Hawkins. Another snap DDT. And I'll go for the cover, go for the pinfall here. 1, 2, 3, and again Tommy Douglas kicks out. Now you can start to see the frustration on Richard Hawkins' face. Richard Hawkins, given everything he has, we've yet to see the double underhook Kanbaji DDT, a special move that we've seen him use in the past. We've yet to see that. We've yet to see the Walls of Jericho, the high elevated Boston Crab. But don't think that he's not ready to use that yet. And there's the clothesline sending Tommy Douglas into the steel steps. And Richard Hawkins now, again showing off his arm muscles. And again, rather stupid. Tommy Douglas has bigger arm muscles than he does. But again, the new ego and a huge drop kick there. I mean, no matter how big his ego is, that was a beautiful drop kick by Richard Hawkins. Rivals Mavens. And oh, there's an atomic drop there by Hawkins. I want you fans to count how many atomic drops Richard Hawkins is using this matchup. I mean, you talk about spam. And Douglas again kicking out. Richard Hawkins has got to be thinking to himself, what do I have to do to pin this man? What do I have to do to keep this man down in this matchup? And again, right there's another atomic drop by Richard Hawkins. That has to be at least 4 in this match. And oh, there's a forearm taking down Tommy Douglas. And now Richard Hawkins, I thought he was heading towards the top rope, but I guess he don't do that no more. Now he undoes the turnbuckle. And look at this. How sick is this? He wants to punish his friend. There's a huge insecurity there by Richard Hawkins. As he now goes for the cover, but Douglas getting his hand on the rope. I mean, you're not going to pin him from that. You need to hit a super high impact move. You expect to pin him, and there's a power slam. Tommy Douglas fights back with the power slam. Going with the cover here. Has he won this match? 2, 3, no. Richard Hawkins gets the shoulder up. A surprise power slam out of nowhere. Shades of Randy Orton with that. And Tommy Douglas sending Hawkins back into the ropes. And there's a huge clothesline. Tommy Douglas now trying to get back in this matchup. And you see Douglas pumping himself up. And now Douglas going to send Richard Hawkins. And oh my god, Hawkins went spine first in the unprotected turnbuckle. I don't think Douglas has realized yet. Douglas has not realized what Hawkins has done with that turnbuckle. And now sends him back there again. And you can see the pain that Richard Hawkins is in. And Tommy Douglas is in full control right now. Tommy Douglas taking out his former friend. And there's another clothesline going for the cover. But Richard Hawkins grabbing the ropes. And these fans are here solely behind Tommy Douglas. And oh wait, he's realized now. Richard Hawkins is in trouble. And Douglas thinking about it. But he's going to do it. And no, Richard Hawkins, he's able to protect himself. Tommy Douglas took too long. He took too long to hit his face in the steel rings. And now Richard Hawkins dragging him towards. And Richard Hawkins ain't going to think twice about him. Oh my god. He's not going to think twice about this. As he's now just pounding Tommy Douglas on that unprotected turnbuckle. On the steel ring brass. And as he continues to just bounce him back and forth. And now there's blood. There is blood that is being shed. Richard Hawkins busting Tommy Douglas open. And now a back suplex. And Douglas is, he has no idea where he is right now. He is bleeding from that left eye. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the double underhook Kanbaji DDT there by Richard Hawkins. And busted open from the unprotected turnbuckle. There is no way that Douglas is kicking out of this. And this one is over. 2, 3, and Richard Hawkins pins Douglas tonight at Backlash. My God, you talk about showing absolutely no respect. Richard Hawkins clearly cheating in this matchup. Undoing the protective turnbuckle. I mean, Douglas, from all of what he's gone through in the last 2 weeks, he still thought about it. He still didn't take advantage of the match when he could. Richard Hawkins, though, when he had the opportunity, he didn't think twice about smashing his friend's, well, former friend's face on the unprotected turnbuckle. Ladies and gentlemen, this rivalry is far from over. But on this night of Backlash, Richard Hawkins picks up the victory.